Yeah, I think we're just gonna chill out and play a game of Arkham today. So, just so you guys can see the deck here, we're gonna be playing Ashcan Pete through the Blob today. This is a 9 experience deck that I put together the other day. It's not taboo compliant, but I don't think that really changes too much. I mean, the only thing it would change is that it would make Scrapper here a 5 experience card rather than a 3 experience card. So I think other than that, it's pretty taboo compliant, and Scrapper is not really a necessary part of the deck, but certainly helps to bump our skill tests up by a pretty sufficient amount when we combine it with things like Mana LeBranche. So as far as other individual card selections that I made, I wanted to make sure I had plenty of ways to deal damage, aside from using Duke once or twice a turn. So I decided to use a backup copy, or my backup spell as Shriveling. And I've also included one copy of the Moonstone, which is a nice card to be able to discard to ready Duke or ready Madame LeBranche, and then we can play the Moonstone and get a nice buff to our stats. And I'm also trying out Glimmer of Hope, which seems pretty good in Pete too. You can discard them to either Cornered or to Pete's ability, ready Duke or get +2 to a skill test, which is nice. So I'm looking forward to that. I think apart from that, it's a pretty standard looking survivor deck. We're playing, you know, obviously like Live and Learn and Lucky. I'm playing one Scrounge. It was kind of the only amount that I could actually fit into the deck while still wanting to play everything else. So that's ultimately why I only have one Scrounge in the deck. I had thought about maybe taking out one of these skill cards, but I think one Scrounge is a good number. And Magnifying Glass is in there to help Duke investigate, which is nice. That's a nice little tech thing that you can do with him. And you can also have two and play at once, so you can have a base of 6 when you investigate and move with Duke. So that's nice. Track Shoes is also surprisingly good in this deck. So even with just Track Shoes on its own, it's a 4v3, but then you can pump a resource with Scrapper. Or you can play Moonstone and you can be upwards of a 5 before committing any skill cards, or discarding a card to Cornered. And I went with Madame LeBranche over something like Peter Sylvester, because we want a way to draw cards and gain additional resources, and Madame LeBranche is great for both of those things. So still on the train for another 15 minutes. Ah, guten Abend. Nice to see you fine Europeans back here as always. Yeah, we're just kind of going over the deck and just kind of explaining my thought process between some of the card selections here. I think most of them are pretty standard, but just a couple corner cases, and I'm really hoping Glimmer of Hope works out well. This might be more of a min card, I'm not sure yet, but we'll see going into the game. So why don't we go ahead and get into the game itself here. Okay, so yeah, just so you guys can have another quick look at the deck here. It's only 9 experience too, as there really isn't a lot of like upgraded survivor cards I think you really want, especially when you're playing Scrounge. I think being able to recur Lucky and things like that is actually a pretty compelling reason not to upgrade your Luckies. And it, like the bonus of drawing a card is nice, but certainly not, I think, worth the 4 experience and the additional weakness in standalone. Yeah, I would agree, Penguins. So yeah, as I said earlier, we're going to be playing through the Blob that ate everything. It was recently released, so I'm excited to play this in standalone. I have Glimmer of Hope has been hit or miss for you. Great idea, but the action to pick it up is a big limitation. Yeah, I think in this deck in particular, it'll be okay, because we can essentially use, you know, if we draw them all pretty early on, we can hopefully, you know, we'll be able to get pretty good value out of discarding them either with Pete or with Cornered, and then being able to pick up 3 cards for a single resource seems pretty good. And before I actually start the game, let me make sure that all the channel point rewards are refreshed. I had those swapped out for or I had them turned off because I wasn't playing Arkham. So let me make sure these are on. All right, there we go. So that should be good. Alrighty, nice. And I can probably turn this off. Okay, nice. Okay, so yeah, as I was saying, I have had the chance to play this. I played it at Beneath the Waves last year, shortly after it came out. I didn't play it in the Epic multiplayer version. We played a single group. It was four of us, and I weirdly enough, I played Pete in that version as well. The deck was a little different. I didn't play Scrapper or Plucky or anything like that, but my experiences with Pete, I've really enjoyed Plucky and Scrapper in the deck. So that's kind of my thought process going into all that. And without any further ado, let's get into setup here. All right. So incident report 8-L-O-8, Thursday, July 5th, 1928, Blackwater, Massachusetts. 03:12 hours. Impact event just outside of Blackwater. Intercepted police call. Agents set to investigate. Interviewed local farmer Ron Graham. Claims meteor was several feet wide, greenish hue. Crater roughly 100 yards in diameter. Radiation detected in outlying area. Recommended immediate quarantine and further observation by research team. Situation under control. It was not under control. That was the report the G-men took when they first arrived. For the next few days, the town of Blackwater was on lockdown. The impact was all that they talked about in the papers, but not much was known aside from the enormous crater and the effect it had on the countryside. Nobody was allowed to leave the town, and only those approved by the shadowy government agency were allowed to enter. Those unfortunate few included high-ranking government agents and a team of researchers from nearby Miskatonic University, who were summoned to investigate the meteor itself. For the rest of the town's inhabitants, it was a strange occurrence, nothing more, until the meteor hatched. Yeah, very Color Out of Space vibes there. And I forgot to grab a glass of water, so ha! I will be right back. Sack of Lang. What? It does, yeah. Blackwater sounds very similar to Darkwater. I wonder if that's where they drew the inspiration for the name of the town. Blackwater was a private security firm used by the U.S. Army in Iraq. Oh, guilty of war crimes. Nice. I mean, that sounds like the U.S. government. All right. So we read all that. I saw it with my own eyes. When the anomaly emerged, the first thing it did was devour the team of researchers who had been sent to collect and study samples for the meteor. The next thing it did was devour their lab equipment. Then Ron Graham's tractor. Then his house. Then its entirety. Oh, in its entirety. It continued to grow and spread, devouring everything in its path. I barely escaped with my life. When the army arrived, they thought they could kill it with bullets and shells. Everything they threw at the creature was devoured, one round after the next. Then it split into hundreds of smaller pieces of itself, and the army was quickly overwhelmed. While the battle raged on, myself and the others back in town saw lights and shapes in the sky above. Something was up there, waiting, biding time. The quarantine still holds and we're stuck in the middle of it. It won't be long before the anomaly has grown large enough to devour everything in Blackwater. And if that happens, who could possibly stop its rampage? What? 233% CP. How is that even possible? I mean, unless you're watching it on Chrome. Nate, can I help? Oh, yeah. He doesn't need a new PC. If it's his work computer, man, that thing's a beast. Penguin and I like to chat tech on our Discord server. Yeah, Chrome is terrible, man. Chrome is very, very CPU and RAM hungry. The next talk command shows things out of 100%, and when you have 16 cores, you can get up to like 1400% CPU usage. Huh. Interesting. I mean, I have a 6-core processor, so. Man, you need to get like a Threadripper or something then, man. That'd be insane numbers. I got 24-core. What is it, like 48-thread processor? Alright, so on to setup here. So we've gathered all the cards. We're playing in regular single group mode. So we've gathered all that. We've set all the cards aside. Search the blob that ate everything in counter set for the following cards and set them aside. We did that. Put subject 8LO8 enemy into play next to the agenda deck. It is not at any location. Okay. Alright, so yeah, so the only thing that we really have to do in TTS is, I believe, the random location setup, so. Alright, so set up the locations according to the guidelines below. See suggested location placement on the next page. Shuffle the quarantine zone locations together and remove one of them from the game. Yoink, okay, so we'll remove that one from the game. Put the crater into play. Okay, that's in play. Now take the research site, temporary HQ, and two random quarantine locations. Shuffle them and place each of them connected to the crater. In a random order. Okay. Two random ones. Okay. So it's this, this, and then two of these. Okay, that's weird, but okay. Alrighty, so that's that. Take the fungus mound and three random quarantine zone locations and shuffle them and place them in one of the four positions in the outer ring farthest from the crater. Okay, I see what's going on here. So we take this and then three others. Two and three. And then you place one like here, 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 and here. And then I'm assuming you just filled up the other locations like this. Yeah, like that. Yeah, penguins, you do like machine learning and stuff like that, so you actually like have use for all that power. You said you use, what is it, like two Titans, a couple of Quadros, and something else? Yeah, that's got to be interesting work. That's something that I would probably enjoy doing. Really should get into tech. That's what I get for not following my dad's advice. Oh, sorry, yeah. Six 2080s. Are they TIs or just regular 2080s? Okay, and then shuffle the remaining cards to make the encounter deck. And then we'll have to refer to this guy quite a bit, unfortunately, if we draw Reality Acid. So let's go ahead and shuffle this up. And we are ready to rock and roll here. So here's our starting assets. Yeah, 2080 TIs. Whew. Yeah, fun fact, those are like $1,200 a piece. If you were to buy them on your own. Okay, this hand's not... that's pretty bad. So we're looking for things like Plucky, Manimal Branch. I mean, one flashlight is enough, I think. Probably get rid of all these other cards, though. Okay, let's draw four new cards here. Oh yeah, we got Amnesia for our weakness. Okay, that's not a terrible hand. Yeah, okay, not the worst. Yeah, easily. Yeah. I don't think Amnesia's as bad in this deck though, Vase. Just because we have, like, our whole shtick is to, like, you know, get a bunch of cards out of our hand anyway, so. Okay, and then what location do we start at? I didn't remember. Let's see, each investigator begins play at temporary HQ. Okay, so we begin play here. At first, few are allowed near this military encampment. A large black tent is set up in the center of the open field, with eyes on the rest of Blackwater. Military trucks are parked outside, though the encampment itself is suspiciously lacking soldiers. You hope this situation hasn't spiraled completely out of control, though you suspect otherwise. Okay, so let's see here. Oh yeah, and we start with a certain amount of countermeasures as well, which I think I just missed that part of setup. If you're playing... trying to remember where it says how many countermeasures you get. I think it's one plus one per investigator? I'm trying to remember. Where is it? Oh, here it is. If you're playing single group mode, place a resource on the scenario as a countermeasure, and two resources if there's three and more investigators. Okay. So yeah, we start with a single countermeasure. Okay, so at temporary HQ, we can spend one of our countermeasures to heal 3 damage, heal 3 horror, gain 5 resources, or draw 5 cards. And it has 2 shroud and 0 clues. We have a doom threshold of 6. Each location is connected to each location adjacent to it. And our objective is, at the start of the round, investigators may spend the requisite number of clues to advance. Beware, advancing will expose the anomaly's weak spot. Be ready for a fight. And then the blob itself is a 30 health extra spatial anomaly. So this is one of the big reasons why I wanted to include shriveling, was that we needed some other way to boost our damage output in case we, like, didn't have the means of continuously using Duke turn after turn. So okay, so we have 3 actions. I think let's spend our first action to play LeBranche. Let's spend a resource. Let's get out this magnifying glass. Let's see, we have 2 actions left of their turn. I'm thinking probably move into one of these quarantine zones and investigate with Duke. So let's do that. So, second action, move, investigate. So we find the desiccated farmland. It's a 3 shroud and a single clue. While you are at desiccated farmland, you cannot gain resources. And as a forced effect, this is at the end of your turn. Or after you end your turn here, you lose a resource. Okay. So we're investigating 3v5. I think that's fine. Because I think our last action is probably going to be a move and investigate again, so... So let's do that. Okay, cultist is a minus two. If this token is revealed during an attack against an enemy, that enemy gains retaliate. Okay, so thankfully we pass, so we get a clue. Yoink, and then let's discard this to ready Duke, and then we'll go ahead and move again. I guess I'm going to move here. So we move to the sewer. Ugh, five shroud, one clue. As an action that says you can test intellect one if you succeed, move to a location up to X connections away from the sewer, where X is the amount you succeed by. Okay, so we're currently 5v5 here. And that's our last action. Debating whether or not I want to commit this, but I think what I'll do is, if worse comes to worse, I'll just play this. So 5v5. That's a minus three. After the skill test ends, subject 8LO8 devours each card that was committed to the skill test. Well, good thing we didn't commit anything. All right, so I guess I will live and learn. Oh, that'd only be a 4 or 5 versus 5 again, right? Are devoured cards lost forever? Yes. They're essentially removed from the game. And the blob can devour all sorts of strange things, which might be weird to reenact in TTS. Like, there's a couple that are just kind of silly, so we'll probably just honestly end up ignoring them. Yeah, I think the way live and learn works, though, is that we wouldn't be able to get the base skill back from Duke. I think it's just you, man. Though I'm not getting frame rate issues, but it is, weirdly enough, not sending a total amount of data. Okay, apparently it's just you. Maybe try refreshing Chrome. Or killing Chrome where it stands. So, rules question, chat. How does live and learn work in combination with Duke? Would I be investigating at a base 4 again? Okay. Well, I mean, if that's the case, I'll probably... I guess I will live and learn. And then that's going to be 4, 6, 7 versus 5. Damn it. Fine, be that way. It really didn't want me to pass that test. Okay. Well, there's no enemies, so let's go to upkeep. Resource card. Ooh, there's Plucky. Nice. So Plucky and Scrapper is actually a really pretty potent combination. And I like that these composures are fast, too. I think these are pretty underrated overall. Yeah, try Firefox. Let's go ahead and add a Doom, though. So we're at 1 of 6 in our encounter card for the turn. It got me! Put it into play in your threat area. At the end of the round, place a resource on its got me. And then if there are 6 or more resources on its subject, 8LO8 devours you. If you're at the research site, you can spend a countermeasure to discard it and an action. Well. Yeah, I've really come around to these cards. I think Plucky's probably the best one, just because I think there's the most amount of investigators that benefit it from its class. And even off-class, too. Like, off-class Survivor is one of the strongest off-classes in the game, so... It boosts pretty good stats. Like, obviously, anything that boosts intellect is probably useful, so... The Mystic one, like, only buffs, like, spells, if I remember correctly, yeah? Whoa, that was weird. Yeah, I can't remember what it does. Need to set up a night bot that's like Diana Standbot. Okay, well, let's... So we're gonna have to eventually make our way up here. So, like, do I want to go like this way and then this way? So we need two clues. And that's at the start of the round, so we'd have to do that before Mythos phase. We have a couple of turns, so I think I'm just gonna kind of investigate these outside quarantine locations. So let's go here, and we find the church. Man, I love that art, like the ooze going out of the church. That's great. Force round a single clue. If there's no clues on the church, you can choose an ooze enemy at church or a connecting location. Move the chosen enemy one location away from the church and automatically evade it. Group limit once per game. That's a pretty sweet ability. Okay, so yeah, we're moving and investigating 4v5. I think what I'll do here, during my test window, I will play Plucky. And then so we're currently 4v5, let's go 6-7v5? And we can use LeBron for a resource. Okay. Actually, I might want to save the branch in case I need to draw a card, so. But yeah, so we're committing to, so we're 7v4 here. Oh my god, wow. Man, the bag is showing up its ugly head today. Okay, fine. Man, that was brutal. Yeah, damn. Now I wish I had done that. Well, in any case, I mean, we need clues. Guess what I can do is pitch, draw. Oh, there we go. There's a moonstone. That's handy. And then I'm going to, I guess, move up here and investigate. Because I don't think 4v5 is going to be enough to investigate that, so. Okay, so we find the slimy streets. Three shroud and two clues. Forest, after you discover any number of clues from the slimy streets, reveal that many random tokens from the bag. For each skull or autofail token revealed this way, you take a damage or a horror. Oh, nice. Thanks. Thank you for the blessings. Let me, remember to pull those objects out. Which is funny because I remember to do it in the other save file I have. Is it four? Have I been missing blessed ones? Man, I gotta really like pay attention to that. It's because I have to alt tab out of the game to actually see them. You just did three in a row. Jeebus. Did you really? One, two, holy shit, yeah you did. Okay, so I need to add two more. Blessed be, well good thing you guys remind me before skill tests. That's all I gotta say. Nice, cool. All right, so yeah, second action was to move and investigate the slimy streets. So we're currently 3v5 here. I don't think I'm gonna commit or spend anything else. I don't have any resources left, so. Yeah, there we go. Woo! Nice. Bam. I think we passed. Hey, very nice. That's sweet. So we get a clue, and then we have to reveal a random token. Okay, it wasn't a skull, so we don't have to take any damage or horror. We grab this clue here. And then I guess I'll use Duke again, and we'll move up this way. We find another desiccated farmland. Oh, that's too bad. Oh, we don't have any resources to lose, so could be worse. All right, that's our last action. We're testing 3v5 here. You could refresh your browser and see if that helps. And a zero, nice. Sweet, okay. Thanks, Duke. Why do we even use Pete anyway? We just use Pete to, like, ready Duke. Duke is the real investigator here. I'm very excited for Barkham when he gets, when he finally gets the recognition he deserves. All right, so that was our turn. We'd have to lose a resource end of our turn, but we don't have any to lose. Oops. And then we can't gain resources while we're here, unfortunately, so we'll just have to go to upkeep as normal without gaining a resource. Okay. So at the end of the round, we're gonna have to place a resource here. And once there's six or more on here, we die. So we're gonna have to get rid of this. All right, let's go to Mythos phase. To doom a six, counter card. Oh my good God. What the fuck? I shuffled the deck, man, I swear. God damn it. I'm shuffling it again just to be safe. That is, God damn it. That's just my luck. Okay. I mean, it's not like the end of the world. It's just annoying because I don't, like, we have to get another countermeasure and then we'll have to get rid of this at some point. Which is just kind of annoying. Well, I guess we can at least move and investigate the research site. So let's go here. Okay, so we can spend two clues here as an action to gain a countermeasure. Okay, unfortunately there's no clues to be had. We could think about committing resourceful to get live and learn back. Six or more. I don't think it's a combination. I think each one is treated individually. And so we're testing 2v5 here. Well, that sucks. Wow, that is some serious bugginess. I mean, I'll take it, but we don't get anything out of it, unfortunately. I guess what we can do is use Madame LeBranche for a resource. Okay. Let's spend an action and a countermeasure to get rid of this. And then I guess what I'll do is spend two clues to get a countermeasure? Because we're not really, like, ready to fight anything, unfortunately. Like, we still need... I think we still need a couple... We at least need some sort of way to deal pretty significant damage. Because we're really only fighting at, like, a base 4, so... So I think I'm just going to spend two clues and get a countermeasure. And then that'll be my turn. So we'll go to upkeep, resource, and card. I would like to be able to play this Moonstone at some point as well, so let's go to Mythos, redoom a six. This would have a resource on it. Corrosive Ooze, or Corrosive Slime. Revelation, test willpower 4 for each point you fail by. Subject 8L08 either devours one of your resources or a random card from your hand. Okay, I kind of want my resources, so I'd really appreciate if you wouldn't eat those. Currently 4 versus 4. Could commit this for 5. Yeah, I mean, it's either... We could potentially, like, lose a bunch of cards, which I also don't want to do, so... So let's go 5v4 here. Wow, so many Elder Signs. That's ridiculous. I mean, I'll take it, but damn. This is like the opposite of the other games I've been playing recently. I swear, the bag is bugged, man. Okay. So, I mean, while we're here, why don't we spend a countermeasure and get rid of this stupid thing? I mean, it sucks to do that, but it is what it is. Part of me wants to gain a resource and then use Duke. I mean, we could wait a turn. Yeah, let's just wait a turn, I think. Let's move and investigate. Damn it. So we find the oozy lake bed. Two shroud and zero clues. Forced after a manifold enemy spawns at the oozy lake bed, you place a clue on it. That enemy can't take damage this round. Okay. Well, it's unfortunate there's no clues there. So that's going to be 2v5. That's okay. Perfect time to draw an auto fail. Yeah. It's kind of too bad. I mean, we've done a lot of moving around. Guess what I'll do. Yeah, I guess what I'll do is I'll just move down here. I kind of want to save these two cards, so I think the last action is just going to be to move. We move back to temporary HQ, and then we'll go to upkeep. Resource card, okay. Second copy of Mag Glass. I'll go to Mythos phase. And we need to get a move on, though. So, six Doom of four. Oh, there's the Reality Acid. So this is the card you have to refer to the table. That's in, as it says, pages 16 and 19. Are there any connection oddities, or is it pretty much straight orthogonal? Yeah, it's just straight orthogonal, like adjacency, so. So yeah, you can go up and down or left or right. All right, so we have to reveal two random tokens from the bag. Okay, and then we have to consult the table. So we got a minus one and a tablet. Oh no, it devours our precision. So until the end of the next Mythos phase, set your base combat to zero. Esoteric Atlas? Is that what you're thinking of? So the blob devours our precision. Yeah, hemispheric map would also be really good. Is it otherworldly compass? I think that's what it's called. Yeah. Yeah, that's the one that's like, you get to investigate and then it's minus X shroud, where X is the number of connecting locations or something like that. Yeah, so I mean, just look at some of these like ridiculous things. So the blob can devour your cell phone, the chaos bag, all sources of light, the concept of language, your group's food and drinks. Revealed connecting locations. Danke. So many blessings. I feel so blessed to have you all in chat today. Okay. So our base combat is currently a zero. Just gonna put this resource on it to remind us. Oops. Resume. All right, that's Mythos phase. I mean, thankfully we have Duke, which like kind of says, no, thanks, bro. All right. So I think what I'm going to do here is move into the crater and investigate first action. All right, so the crater is one shroud and two clues. Has an action that says spend one countermeasure to deal three damage to subject 8L08 or a manifold enemy at any location. Forced at the end of the round, each investigator at the crater takes a damage. All right, so we're investigating 1v5 here. That seems to be a-okay with me. One versus five? a blessing and a minus three, so that's a minus one, so we pass. Okay, yoink, second clue. And then I think what I'm gonna do is discard this to ready Duke. We'll play it. Whoops, play it. So that's a nice boost to our stats. I'm hoping to find like track shoes or shriveling pretty soon here. We can gain a resource. I don't think we have any other hand assets. Yeah, we don't. So we could just play this other mag glass. Might as well. We don't have cornered either, so. Alright, we had to exhaust Duke to do that. Or no, we readied Duke because we played this. I'm stupid. Okay. Getting ahead of myself. Let's move and investigate here. So we're currently 3v6. Let's make sure there's nothing worth getting out of my discard pile, which there isn't really. Okay. Okay, so we were 6v3, so we pass, and we didn't commit anything, so that's good. So we'll grab this clue. And then that's going to be reveal a token. It's not a scholar or an autofail, okay. Alright, so with last action, could move into this quarantine zone. I forgot about this whole spending countermeasures to deal 3 damage. So we'd have to go back to the research site and spend a lot of time doing that. I think what I'm gonna do is just move here. Alright, and we find the water tower. So the water tower is 4 shroud and a single clue. It has an action that says if there's no clues here, you can test intellect 3 to find the structure's weakness. If you succeed, deal 3 damage to each ooze enemy at water tower and each connecting location. That's helpful. Okay. And that's our turn. Go right into upkeep here. Resource card. We draw lucky. Okay. Mythos. Oops. We're at 5 Duma 6. We really need to actually get going here. And another reality acid. Okay. What is up with all these like drawing doubles of everything today? Plus one, a blessing? I think I just broke the game, guys. I don't think that there is a... Yeah, I think we just genuinely broke the game. This is not accounted for. I do not know how this works. No, it's literally, it's all calculated out. Like every possible combination is calculated on here. Can you zoom in on that header text on page 18? Yeah, sure. Your party's teamwork, each investigator loses on action. That is horseshit. Oh, okay. So if the combination of chaos tokens revealed is not listed, or if the listed aspect cannot be devoured, reveal 2 new tokens. Damn it. Okay, let's try this again. Okay, there we go. There we go. Okay, so we got a cultist at a minus 2. Minus 2 at the top 3 cards of our deck. Lame. Oh, yes, he devoured a weakness. Oh, that's so good. Damn it. Man, that went from really good to really terrible all at once. Damn it. Man, I needed the shriveling and the corner. Dude, that sucks. Man, that is getting terrible. I mean, I'm glad it ate our weakness, but like still. I was hoping it'd eat the other weakness of anything. Dude, that actually kind of really sucks. I was really hoping to draw one of those two cards soon. Okay, so it's beginning of the round. I guess. Do we want to spend the two clues to try to devour or fight the blob? I think we do. Okay, I don't think it's going to get much better, so. So let's spend two clues in advance here. You've seen the anomaly's true heart. It lies beneath the surface of the ooze, pulsing with unseen power and guided its myriad forms with alien hunger. You suspect this organ, whatever it may be, holds the secret to destroying the anomaly once and for all. After hours of investigation, you believe that you have pinpointed the creature's heart. Due to the way it shifts throughout the surface of its all-encompassing body, you know it won't stay in its current form for long. And then you'll have to track it down again. Choose an oozified location, spawn the set-aside vulnerable heart enemy at that location. Extraterrestrial physiology. A forest, after any amount of damage is placed on vulnerable heart, place twice that much damage on subject 8LO8 as well. While an investigator at your location is attacking the vulnerable heart, you can spend a clue to give that investigator +2 combat for this attack, and at the end of the round, you must advance. Okay. So I think we're just going to spawn him at our location. So the vulnerable heart is a X nil nil enemy. Massive retaliate. X is the amount of damage on vulnerable heart. Vulnerable heart cannot be evaded and cannot make attacks of opportunity. Vulnerable heart cannot have more than 15 damage on it. All excess damage is canceled. Okay, so. So yeah, I mean, we're fighting at a base 4, currently to a 0. So I mean, first action, let's bite it. Bite the ooze, Duke. I believe in you. And then we have Lucky as backup if all goes to shite. Yeah, 4 versus 0. Okay, that's 2 damage. And then we place 4 damage on the blob. Okay, and then I guess let's we can ready Duke, and then let's fight it again. This time it's going to be 4 versus 2 with Lucky backup. Could go 4 versus 5 and then gain a resource, and then we could save the Lucky. Because we can't ready Duke again anyway, so I think that's actually probably a good plan. Okay, so we're going to go 5 versus 2 here. Okay, it's another 2 damage. Another 4 damage onto the blob. That's weird. Eat the blob. It says my system failed to connect. It must be Nightbot. Nightbot must be being a punk ass right now. Alright, yeah, I mean, we don't really have much else to do, so I guess we can just move at this point. I mean, dealing 8 damage out of 30 is pretty good, I would say. So I guess we'll just move. Last action. Well, hold on. Actually, because this would move with us. We can't evade it. It's going to deal us a decent chunk of damage. Can I change the name to Night Blob? I don't think you can, unfortunately, though that would be great if you could. My dog's eat everything, too. We could investigate four versus... It'd be four versus four, I guess. Yeah. Not the best odds. I mean, two and two is a lot. Yeah, that's gonna be is what it is, though. Yeah, I guess last action, let's just draw a card then. Okay, so we draw a last chance, that's actually pretty good. Alright, so enemy phase. This guy's gonna bonk us for two and two, so one and one. And then we'll go to upkeep. Okay, so let's see here. So at the end of the round, we have to advance. Mere minutes after its exposure, the pulsating heart retreats back inside the creature's vast body. You'll have to wait for it to reemerge in order to harm it once more. Remove all damage from vulnerable heart, set it aside out of play, and the amount of damage that is removed from this way is X. If X is at least 1, read the following. All around you, the anomaly reels back for a moment, then it erupts into the sky in a massive geyser of anger and hate. You duck for cover as gobs of ooze slam into the ground all over the city, splitting into even more sentient masses. Shuffle the encounter discard pile into the encounter deck and discard cards from the top until manifold enemies with a total of at least X health have been discarded one at a time in a random order. Spawn each of those enemies at different oozified locations. Ugh. Hey. So 3x was 4. So 2 oozlings, okay. And then we get to spawn them at any location. Man, the fact that these things have 3 health sucks. Really kind of sucks for us. Okay. Well, we can do a couple different things here. We could spawn one here. Actually, so I think what we should do is probably spawn one here at the slimy streets. Because we could use the water tower to kill it. And then maybe put one here in the sewer. And then we could use the church to evade it. That seems pretty good, right? Because it's at a connecting location, right? Yeah, so I think that's going to be our plan. And then, let's see here. Blackwater's Bane, Act 3A. You have managed to finally harm the creature directly, but in doing so, you have caused it to split even further. Each ooze enemy gains retaliate and loses the Blob X keyword. So the Blob keyword essentially means that whenever you had defeated, it would deal damage to the Blob. And then at the end of the round, you must advance. The scenario will not end when this act advances. Okay, so we go to Mythos phase, and then we'll have to advance this. From the center of the crater, a ley line of glowing ooze worms its way underground. Cracks appear in the ground throughout the town like tendrils reaching out to stake their claim on Blackwater. It is as though the creature is rooting itself into the earth as it grows. Will the world ever be truly rid of it? Choose 2 oozified locations other than the crater without a copy of Vulnerable Heart. Subject 8LO8 devours both of those locations, along with all non-ooze cards at those locations. Ooze enemies are discarded instead. Shuffle 1 set-aside copy of Cubic Ooze, 1 copy of Grasping Ooze into the encounter deck along with the encounter discard pile. So Grasping Ooze and Cubic Ooze. And then the creature from inside the meteorite continues to digest Blackwater whole. By day 2, nearly all of the town is covered in vibrant green slime. Acid slowly eats away at the buildings, the streets, even the dirt. Will it ever cease? Man, what locations do I even choose here? Guess I could just choose these locations I haven't even been to. Actually, I think choosing these two is probably fine. Because they're not very useful to us. They're actually pretty detrimental. And these might actually have more ways of gaining countermeasures or dealing damage to blob enemies, so... So I think that's pretty reasonable. Okay, so let's draw our encounter card here. We draw Alien Food Chain. Revelation, if there's no manifold enemies in play, Alien Food Chain gains Surge. I don't think these are manifold enemies. Oh, they are. Okay. Otherwise, attach it to the manifold enemy with the least remaining health and fully heal that enemy. Attached enemy gets +1 fight, +1 evade, and gains hunter. Okay, well, we plan on killing this thing this turn, so hopefully that does not come to bite us in the ass. Alright, so that was Mythos phase. Alright, so as far as upkeep goes, this is also out of play. Oops. So I'm just gonna put it over here for now. Basically, the whole cadence of this scenario is like finding the heart, beating it up, dealing damage to the blob, finding the heart, etc., etc. So, all right, so let's see. So I'm thinking action one, try to investigate. Action two, try to test this. Because we're investigating at a six with Duke. And then we could commit like last chance, dig ourselves like three. Yeah, I'd give ourselves three icons. So I'd be two up on that test. I think that seems pretty reasonable. And in either case, we have Lucky as backup, so. So I think that's what I'm gonna do. Let's first action investigate. I'll also commit a resource with this. So that'll be 6-7 versus 4. Okay, that's a pass. Very nice. Grab the clue. Yoink. Can probably get rid of this resource as well. Okay. And then second action, let's do that test. I'll commit this. And then I'll also do the old LeBronch trick. So we'll pump another resource into Plucky as well. So it's going to be 5-6 versus 3. Nice. Sick. So many Elder Signs this game. So many Elder Signs. It's actually kind of silly. Alright, so we deal 3 damage to this. So this will go away. Along with this. So. Call that a win. So I think how this works now is that this is connected this way. That's cool. I mean, it's not like we need to use Duke again this turn, but it's nice to know that he's there. So I think our whole plan was to go back down to the church, so I guess we'll just move last action. We don't need to investigate, so no sense in doing that. Okay, so enemy phase, the blob does not move. I'll go to upkeep, resource card. There it is, there's cornered. Needed that. Cornered is very helpful. Okay, let's go to Mythos phase. We're at 1 doom of 6. And our encounter card is a consuming maw. Alright, test agility 3. Take a damage for each point you fail by. Subject 8L08 devours each card defeated by this effect. Okay. So we're currently at a 4, thanks to our moonstone. I think that's going to be fine. Like, worst comes to worst, we just take a couple damage. I think we should be able to survive that. I'll be really sad if the blob devours Duke. That'll be a sad day. I guess, like, worst comes to worst, if we really wanted to, we could commit Lucky to not take damage, but let's see. I'm feeling lucky today, guys. Oh, that's a minus three. After the skill test ends, it would devour each card committed to it. Okay, so we would take two damage? I could just deny it too. It seems pretty worth it. We'll just deny the two damage. No thanks, Blob. Thanks for trying. Okay. So I think what I want to do here first action is get this cornered down. Let's gain a resource. Let's move and investigate the church. Thankfully, this doesn't have Hunter. So we're investigating 6v4 currently. I think I'm gonna be okay with that. 6v4. 8. Oh man, that's a huge wah-wah. Man, that sucks. Okay, well, fine. Man, that's terrible. What a waste of a blessing. Well, that changes things a little bit. Okay, I could just try to investigate 4 versus 4 here. Which isn't the end of the world, I guess. Because we have Lucky as backup, I guess. Alright, 4 versus 4. Ah, thanks, Manson. You guys are so nice to me. Those blessings have been interesting. Okay, so we're just gonna test 4v4 here, I guess. All right, and then I'll commit Lucky for a clue. We're eventually gonna need those for countermeasures, so there is a good reason to grab clues here. All right. And we also need to grab the clues in order to evade that enemy, so... Okay. Because I'd rather just evade it than have to spend 2 actions and probably a card to kill it, so... And there isn't any benefit to killing the ooze, so... Ooh, last chance. That's a good draw. Okay, Mythos Phase. 2 Doom is 6. Counter card for the turn is a Corrosive Slime. Alright, so we're currently at a 5 willpower, so we have to test versus 4, and then for each point we fail by, you know, either devours a card or a resource from our hand. Okay. I mean, probably gonna lose our cards anyway, so I guess we'll commit this for 5. So that's gonna be 10 versus 4 here. And that is a cultist. Okay, so we pass. Cultist has a minus 2. Alright, so we have no cards in hand, so I guess we'll start by drawing a card. Ooh, second plucky. So we draw an unexpected courage. Oh, because we have cornered. Or we drew a second thing for Duke. So I guess first action we'll do this. We'll move it... I guess we can move it here into temporary HQ. Yeah, it just says move it one location away. That seems fine. I think that's right. I could be wrong, but I'm pretty sure that that's copaesthetic. Okay, and then we automatically evade it, so that was that action. So I guess what I want to do now is I probably want to go back up here. I either want to go here or I want to go here. So So I could try to grab this 5 shroud clue. 6v5. Commit this to be 8v5. And then maybe we could grab a couple more clues down here. Yeah, let's do that. So that was action one. Action two, let's move and investigate with Duke. 6v5, 7, 8v5. Ooh, nice. Okay, so now we have clues to get some countermeasures, which are going to be helpful. Okay, and then we have no cards in hand, so we can't ready Duke again, unfortunately. We already used LeBronch to draw, so I guess last action, let's just move. We'll go ahead and move into this quarantine zone. And we find another Uzi lake bed. So it's a forest. After a manifold enemy spawns here, you place a clue on it and the enemy can't take damage this round. I mean, thankfully we actually have a pretty decent chance at evading these things. Okay, so upkeep, Skywall ready. And then we'll ready our stuff as well. Resource card. Okay, fight or flight. Not the most useful right now. It's always an unexpected courage, though. Okay. 3, Doom 6. Counter card. Oh, well, that was supposed to advance. Fuck me. Okay. Yeah, sorry, that was my fault. I was supposed to do this, like, turns ago. Okay, this is the first time this act has been read. Throughout the struggles, an alien presence has watched your progress with curiosity. Now they descend from orbit in order to hatch their plot. Shuffle each of the set-aside Mego drone enemies into the encounter deck along with the encounter discard pile. I totally forgot about the advancing. As the hours pass, the ooze seeps back into the ground and lies dormant once more. Place one per investigator clues on each revealed oozeified location to a maximum of its clue value. Lead investigator chooses a random set-aside story asset and draws it, revealing the part one trait. And then reset to Act 1A. All right. You are approached by a military officer who informs you of the military's plans to destroy the anomaly using explosives. I tried to tell him why it won't work, but the general was too stubborn to listen, he explains. The explosives are on a timed fuse. If they detonate, it'll only split the creature further and make it even harder to destroy. Orders be damned, we have to stop him. Revelations spawn the set-aside Mego Meddler at the Fungus Mound. He spawns all the way up there. Okay. Put this card and the set aside military plans asset next to the act deck with 5 damage tokens on it. Place one horror token on one different oozeified location furthest from the crater. Horror tokens represent explosives. Okay. That has to be spawned on the different oozeified location farthest from the crater, which I believe is our location. Yeah, it'd have to be spawned here, here, or here. I'm assuming I got to choose, so I'm just going to choose my location. Okay, so the horror tokens represent that, and then I'll go ahead and place 5 damage here. Okay. 4, if there are no explosives, remember that the explosives were diffused. 4, if the military's plan has no damage on it, remember that the But how do I get rid of the horror? Very confused. Put discard set aside. The military plans asset into play next to the Actic with 5 damage tokens on it. Okay. Place a horror token on one different oozified location furthest from the crater. Horror tokens represent explosives. If there's no explosives among locations of play, remember that they were defused. The military's plan has no damage on it. Flip this card over. Maybe there is something that says it here. Okay, there we go. Each location with explosives gains test intellect 3 or agility 3. If you succeed, remove the horror token. Okay, at the end of the round, remove a damage. Okay, there we go. I was gonna say. I don't know why I don't read all the cards. Okay, so the Mego Meddler is a 3/2/4 enemy. While it's ready, it gains force at the start of the enemy phase. Mego Meddler is at a location with explosives. Remove 1 damage from military's plan. Otherwise, move Mego Meddler once toward a location with explosives. That has a victory point. So many enemies. Okay. Alright, so that was that. I was supposed to do that a while ago, but that's fine. Okay, so put Caustic Dissemination into play next to the agenda deck. At the end of the round, each investigator at an oozified location takes 1 damage and 1 horror. Subject 8L08 devours each card defeated by this effect. Okay, I'm just gonna put that there just as a reminder. And let's go to investigation phase. Okay. So we can either test agility or intellect. I mean, we're at a base 4. So I think what I'll do is first action, do that. So we're going to discard that to cornered. That's going to be 4, 5, 6 versus 3. Let's draw a card. Let's go 7 versus 3. Yeah, 7 versus 3 seems fine. Okay, there's a blessing and there's a minus 3. All right, so that's a minus 1 total. That's a pass. This gets defused. And then flip this card over. Thanks for helping me, the officer says once the job is done. I'll make sure our remaining forces know that their conventional tactics are useless against the creature. Perhaps there are other ways we can assist. Put the set-aside Lieutenant Wilson Stewart asset into play under any investigator's control. Remove military's plan from the game. Add Mego Meddler to the victory display. Each investigator heals a horror, gains 1 countermeasure. Nice. Okay. I'm assuming I would heal the horror, so I don't get to heal a horror, unfortunately, but that's okay. I mean, we just gained 2 victory points for a single action. That seems pretty good. Oh, it's in there. Okay. Okay, so Lieutenant Wilson Stewart has a fast action that says exhaust him to discard a card from your hand or from the top of your deck. Then for each willpower icon, you get plus 1 for your next test. Intellect icon, you get to draw a card. Combat icon, you get to heal a damage or horror from him. And then if it's an agility icon, you get to gain a resource. I mean, to bump Madame LeBron? I don't know. That doesn't really seem worth it to me. Yeah, I don't really think this guy's worth it. Do I have to add him? I think I do, though, unfortunately. Yeah, fortunately I do. No, sorry, Madame LeBlanche. I think Lieutenant Wilson Stewart is going to be devoured by the blob, because I kind of like having Madame LeBlanche. Okay, so that was action one. I guess action two we can move, and then action three? I think we're okay with taking a damage here. So action three, we're going to move and investigate with Duke. And that's going to be six versus one. Okay, that's still a pass. That's a clue. Yoink. Okay. And then, let's see here. So at the end of the round, we're gonna have to take a damage and a horror. And then we have to take a damage because we're here. Okay. So, let's go to upkeep first. Resource card. Okay, there's track shoes. Okay, so we have to take two damage and a horror. So I guess we'll take a damage, and then we'll take a damage and a horror on Lieutenant Wilson Stewart. We find track shoes, that's pretty sweet. Hopefully we'll have the resources to play it soon. Not have to commit it. Okay, we're at four Doom of six. We find an oozling. It spawns in an empty, oozified location. I guess we'll spawn it here? I would have also had to have put clues, but here, 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 here. I think that's it. I guess one would have gone here too. Yeah, I'll outspawn it there. Put a clue there because of its ability. Yeah, that seems right. Okay. Okay, so that's gone. No, so Plucky only says that you have to assign horror onto it before your investigator card. It doesn't say anything about that you can't put horror on any other assets. Fun fact. So you can assign it to your allies and stuff, but you have to assign it to Plucky first. Yeah, it just means that if I take horror on Pete, I have to put it here first. Okay. I mean, we have a decent amount of countermeasures. So we're going to have to spend two clues, which I think I'm going to do. Because we can fight and then discard this and fight again. Seems fine. We're gonna have to essentially do this four times, so. Yeah, let's do that. Yeah, I think you're right, FaZe. Okay, so I'm going to spend two clues to advance here. Alright, so choose an oozified location and then spawn this set aside vulnerable heart at that location. After any amount of damage is placed on the vulnerable heart, you place twice as much damage on the blob as well. So this is going to spawn at our location. Okay. Got three actions. Let's first action fight this thing. That's going to be zero versus Zero versus four. Hoping for no tentacle. Nice. Okay. Do damage. Oops. And then we'll put another four damage on the blob. So the blob has taken 12 out of 30 damage. First action. Second action, let's discard this. Ready Duke, do it again. Currently two versus four. Let's go. I think I probably also discard the top card of my deck. Ah, oh, of course it's the friggin' shriveling. Okay. So we get to heal a damage or a horror from him, so I guess we'll heal a horror? Yeah. I think that's fine. I was hoping to draw a willpower icon and not discard the shriveling. God damn it. It's fine. Okay, so we're, what, 2v5? No, 2v4. 2v4. Debating on whether or not I want to pump resources into Scrapper. I could spend a clue as well. Yeah, I think I'd rather spend a clue. So we're going to spend a clue to give ourselves plus 2 because of the ability on the act deck. So let's see, that's going to be 2, 4, 6 versus 2. And a minus 3, alright. So he takes another 2 damage. And then the blob takes another 4 damage. Suck on that, blob. And then last action. Fortunate we can't. I also don't want to stay here. So I think I'm just going to move here. Last action. Because I don't want to take another damage from being stuck in the crater, so. So that's going to be fine. Because we can essentially just use Duke to grab additional clues if need be, so. Okay, so let's see. Enemy phase. This guy's going to hit us. So that's 2 and 2. We'll... we could go like this. I think I'm just going to take 1 and 2 here. And then we have to take a damage somewhere. So just take a damage. And this will go away. And then that's at the end of the round. Okay. So upkeep. Draw an overpower, okay. That'll be hopefully useful later on. And then at the end of the round, we advance. Alright, and then the whole spiel about having to shuffle this and then put out a bunch of manifold enemies. The cubic ooze! Where does it spawn? Spawn each of those enemies at different oozified locations. Okay. Just says that any at different oozified locations. Confused exactly how this works? This is different. So, can I like spawn it down here? I guess I would spawn it here. It has to be an oozified location, so I mean, yeah, I guess we'll just spawn it here. Okay. That'll be fine. Let's draw our encounter card. We're at 5 of 6. And we draw an oozling. No, any empty oozefed location. And I guess that's going to be here. We could put it here. That would spawn a clue. Okay, that's fine. So each ooze enemy gains retaliate and loses blob X keyword. At the end of the round, we have to advance. So we're going to get another way to gain countermeasures here. So I think what I'm going to do here, first action, let's get a countermeasure via this. Because I'm gonna save these countermeasures and go into the crater, and then we're kind of pick these guys off. So let's see, where do I want to go? I guess I could move up here and investigate, and we can kind of like make our way back down. Alternatively, I could play track shoes. Yeah, let's do that. Actually, second action, track shoes, and that allowed me to kind of more easily move around the map, because we're currently at a 5 agility, so I don't think we need to go to the fungus mound for any particular reason. Yeah, that seems fine. And then what I can do is kind of like hop over this location and go here. This enemy would have actually spawned here, I guess. Yeah, so I think that's what I'm going to do. Last action, Duke, and then we'll move into the crater, and then we'll attempt to test agility 3 versus 5. And we pass, okay. And we'll move here, and then we'll investigate this location. It's gonna be 5 versus 6, and I don't think I want to discard this for that. I think I'd rather save this to fight the vulnerable heart, if possible. Yeah, let's just do that. Ooh, nice. And we pass. So that's cool. We'll get that clue. Okay, enemy phase. I think any of these hunt just gives them retaliate. Yeah, okay, so let's go to upkeep and then we'll advance. Oh, that is terrible. Okay, ugh, gross. I mean, we knew it was coming, but still. Okay, so end of the round, we're gonna have to advance. All right, alright, so we have to place clues back on these locations up to their clue value. This gets a clue. This gets a clue. None of these other locations get a clue. Okay. Drive off the Migo. Oh, goodness. Reports from survivors throughout the town tell of another force of creatures descending from above and collecting globs of ooze all over Blackwater. What are these other alien creatures, and what is their goal? So we spawn the set-aside Migo General at the Fungus Mound and place a clue on the Fungus Mound. Put this card into play next to the Act Deck. If Migo General is defeated or if there are no clues on the Fungus Mound, remember that the Migo were driven off. There are 4 more clues. There are 4 more clues on the Mongoose Mound. Remember that the secret of the ooze was stolen and flip this card over. Oh, that's right. You can get a sick weapon. Then we place a clue here. Yeah, it keeps weirdly disconnecting and reconnecting. What is the best... I'm not sure, Manson. I mean, I would assume any browser is fine as long as your connection's fine. Might be a latency thing, just in general. Okay, so forced, after Amigo General attacks you, move one of your clues to the fungus mound. Ugh. And he has Hunter. Okay, that's rude. We might have to go kick this thing's ass. Okay, unfortunately we're gonna have to deal with this turn though. So let's draw our... go to Mythos phase. We're gonna have to advance as well. As the anomaly spreads throughout the town, the cracks in the earth become more prominent. In the middle of the night, a terrible sound like a growling stomach rumbles beneath the ground. Green ooze begins to erupt from within the cracks overflowing throughout the town. It is clear now that no quarantine can hold this creature. If it is not stopped here, surely it will spread throughout the world. Choose two oozified locations other than the crater without a copy of Vulnerable Heart. Subject 8L08 devours both of those locations along with all non-ooze cards. Ooze enemies are discarded instead. Okay. So, I guess this location and this location? Not particularly useful to us anymore because we've already used their effects. Oops, I'd take the clue, not the location. Take the, ah! There we go. We'll just put these over here. Okay. Oops. So let's delete this. The map continues to get smaller and smaller. By the third day, the anomaly threatens to overtake the quarantine zone. The acid within its body can devour not just the creature's objects and buildings, it is also capable of consuming thoughts, concepts, emotions, or other aspects of reality. You realize now that this creature threatens not only the lives of humanity, but the fabric of existence itself. We have a doom threshold of 8. Okay. That reset to Act 1A. Okay. So now we need a couple clues as well. Okay. And this thing's gonna hunt us. Yeah, unfortunately, we're gonna have to... we're gonna have to spend 2 actions to get rid of this. No ifs, ands, or buts about that. And then I guess what we can do... I don't really want to move either. Guess we could draw a card last action. Yeah. Just because I don't want to move and have that guy hunt us. So I think that's what we're going to do. So, oops. So we're going to draw a card. Okay, we draw a copy of Take Heart. So go to enemy phase. This Migo General will move into the research facility or the research site. And then we'll go to upkeep. Okay, we draw Madame LeBranche. That's a good draw. More soak. Always helpful. Okay, Mythos phase. 1 doom of 8. And our encounter card is Replication. Find the manifold enemy with most damage on it. Discard cards from the top of the encounter deck until another manifold enemy with equal or lower printed health is discarded, spawn that enemy at the same location, then distribute the damage on both of those enemies so that the remaining health on both enemies is as equal as possible. If no enemy is spawned by this effect... okay, well, they all have no damage on it, so I'm just going to assume this surges. Oh, goodness gracious. The grasping ooze. Nearest oozeified location, hunter, after you perform a melee attack against grasping ooze. Subject 8L08 devours that card. Ugh. Hope you didn't bring your machetes. Oh, goodness gracious. Nearest oozeified location. That would be our location. Okay, change of plans. We gotta kill that thing. I mean, thankfully it will deal damage to the blob, so. Okay. Yay. It has a three? So we're gonna have to Duke fight, I think. We could Duke evade as well. So let's Duke. 4, 5, 6 versus 3. Okay, we deal 2 damage. Let's ready Duke. Oh, we get to draw a card. Let's draw a card. Okay, we draw a resourceful. That's actually pretty good. Let's discard this take heart to ready Duke and do it again. And then let's commit this resourceful. That's going to be 5 versus 3. Go 6 versus 3. Okay. Another 2 damage. And then we get a card back with resourceful. I think it's going to be last chance. Yeah, that seems fine. And then last action, we're going to fight, I guess, just with Pete. It's going to be 2-6 versus 3 again. 2 plus 4. Seems fine. There we go. Bam! 5 damage in a single turn. That's what I like to see. Okay, so I just want to make sure about the rules about the blob mechanic. I think it says here. Alright, so many of the enemies in this scenario are pieces of the anomaly which have broken apart into their own sentience. Defeating these enemies damages the anomaly known as Subject 8L08. As an enemy with Blob X is defeated, deal X damage to Subject 8L08. So we deal 3 damage to the Blob as well. So that's nice. I'm glad we passed all those tests. So this guy gets discarded, and we deal 3 damage to the Blob. Okay, so we're at, what? 8, 12, 16... 19 damage out of 30? We're getting close. Okay. Yeah, that was our turn, so let's go to enemy phase. This guy's gonna move again. I guess he could technically move here. It's technically just as far, so that seems fine. Let's do that. Okay, upkeep, resource card, draw another take heart. So one of these cards is Glimmer of Hope, one of these cards is something else. Oops, that's not what I wanted to do. I think one of them is Lucky as well, right? We've only seen a single Lucky, and one of them is Glimmer of Hope. If I didn't already say that. Yeah. Okay. Seems fine. Ah, so many machetes. Man, I couldn't have used machete to defeat that blob enemy. Would have eaten it. Would have eaten our machete. Is that enough machetes for you? And I think I missed a blessing as well. My stupid chat app had to reconnect. Machete. I think that is a sufficient amount of machete. Alright, 2 doom of 8. And we find a wave of ooze, oh god! Test willpower 3, take a horror for each point you fail by. Subject 8 LOA devours each card defeated by this effect. Okay, we are currently at a 5 willpower versus 3. I think that's fine. I want to save my cards to do other things, so. Nice, and we get an Elder Sign, so that's a pass. I'm glad I didn't commit anything. We've drawn so many Elder Signs this game, that is nuts. Okay, so, let's go to our turn here. I think what I want to do, I kind of want to get this branch down. So we could like do this. Oops. Gain a resource. Could save this resource as well. Or save it for a card. So I think I could move investigate. Unfortunately, this Migo thing is going to attack us. Alternatively, I could not play the Lebranche. But I think the Lebranche is going to be super useful. I think it's worth taking a hit. I think what I'll do... I think it's worth it just because we're going to deal a damage to the Blob anyway. Because we get to just kill one of these things. Certainly, we could just use countermeasures to kill it. Certainly, we could move here, try to kill it, but... I think what I'm going to do is just move investigate. I think I'm going to be okay just taking that hit. And then maybe next turn we can kill the Migo General. How much damage does it deal, actually? 1 and 1? Yeah, I think that's fine. Alright, so we're going to investigate 1v6 here. Blessing... Cultist, okay. That's a pass. Get a clue. Grab this. So alternatively, we could, like, move. Yeah, we've drawn a lot of Elder Signs. It's pretty nuts. Okay, so we can either defeat it or grab a bunch of clues. I almost kind of like these things just being here because they don't hunt, so. So I could last action, like move and track shoes. That's fine. Let's do that. So we'll move and then we're going to attempt to move again. 3v5. Wow. Okay. That's really good. Move again. All right. So the fungus mound is 5 shroud with a single clue on it. And then it has an action to spend a countermeasure and choose a Migo enemy at any location and test intellect 0. For each point you succeed by, deal 1 damage to the chosen enemy to a maximum of 5. Okay. So that's fine. So I think we'll be able to pretty easily investigate that location during our turn. But before we do any of that, let's make sure we gain a resource. That's Lebranche. Migo General will move back into the research site. Go to upkeep, gain a resource, and draw a copy of Lucky, Mythos Phase, and we're running out of time, too. Okay, so we're at 3 Doom of 8, and we draw another copy of Reality Acid. A 0 and a Cultist. Your group's food and drinks. It cannot be consumed until your group has dealt at least 3 damage to subject 8 LO8. No, my beer! How dare you! Asshole. Oh, that's rude. I'm gonna put this over here so I'm not even tempted to do that. How dare the blob eat my food? What an asshole. Okay. So we need to get that clue. I think that's going to be the easiest way to get rid of what ails us. So we'll go ahead and investigate 6, 7, 8. Pitching that to cornered. Then we have this as backup. Seems fine. First action. 8 versus 5. Minus 2, that is a pass. That's a clue. Okay. Bada bing, bada boom. And then we do this. Amigo, we're driven off. Chittering unnaturally, the alien general flees. Its strange weapon unhinges from its arm and clatters to the ground in front of you as it flies into space. Put the set-aside Mego weapon story asset into play under any investigator's control. Add Mego General and this card to the victory display and search the encounter deck discard pile and all play areas for each copy of Mego drone and remove them from the game and gain a countermeasure. Nice. And this guy enters the victory display. You go away. You go away. You go away. Actually, me go away. I'm so fucking clever. Okay, nice. That frees up our board a bit. So we could move. We could move investigate with Duke again if we really wanted to. I think what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna move back into the crater, I think. So let's see, we're at 19 of 19 of 30 damage. If we deal 3 damage, that'll be 21. Or 22, that would be exactly enough, okay. And we get the weapon too. Yoink. So the Mego weapon is a 2-cost asset that takes up a hand slot. It has 3 ammo. Spend an ammo to fight. This device fires a blast of anthropic energy. You get +2 combat and deal +1 damage for this attack. If you succeed and the enemy is not defeated, move it one location away from you. If you succeed by 3 or more, deal +1 damage and move that enemy an additional location away. Man, this is like that flux capacitor thing that I designed for Kate Winthrop. This is a sweet weapon. Oh, man. Looks like some kind of, like, Futurama shit. Oh, what's going on, Mr. Aldrich? Nice to see you. Is that supposed to be S. Aldrich or Saldrich? I don't think that changes my plan too much, though, so I think I'm still going to go down here. And then we'll test track shoes. That's going to be 5 versus 3. Womp womp. Okay. I guess that kind of changes things. We don't... I mean, I guess it doesn't really change too much. Because I guess what we can do is we can just spend our 2 clues, fight the vulnerable heart, have Madame LeBron be devoured. Yeah. We have 2 cards left in our deck. Yeah, I think this is just kind of a free action. Because I guess next turn what we can do is move. So alternatively, what we could do is move, fight, deal 3 damage. because we would take a damage this turn, but that I think that's okay. So that'll be our turn, and then end of the round we'll have to take a damage. Good upkeep. Ready our stuff. Resource card. Okay, we draw a live and learn. That was the other card we were missing. Nice. That's actually pretty sweet. Alright, 4 doom of 8. Hopefully not an enemy. Alright, so corrosive slime. Test willpower 4. For each point you fail by, it either devours your resources, one of your resources, or a card at random from your hand. Okay, well, we kind of want both of those things. Because we're going to have to deal with the vulnerable heart. I mean, we could hope to get lucky. Yeah, I guess worst comes to worst, we could lucky, because we're one up on the test right now. Yeah, let's just do that. Oh, well, look at that. Man, I'm so lucky this game. Okay, so let's spend 2 clues. And we're going to do this. So we're going to choose our location, spawn the vulnerable heart, I can talk, at this oozified location. Because this is not a manifold enemy, so we can't just cheese it and deal 6 damage that way. So I guess first action we'll fight 0 versus 4. Mine is 5. Choose up to 5 cards in your hand. Subject 8 LOA devours each of those cards. You get plus 1. Oh, okay. Well, I mean, it's still a 0, so I think we still pass. We deal 2 damage, and then the blob will take 4. Oops. Okay, so 8, 12. That's 23 damage. And then I guess we'll discard live and learn. Ready Duke, fight again. 2 versus 4. 5, 6, 7 versus 4. Gain a resource. Okay, so another 2 damage. Blob will take another 4 damage. Then last action, we'll spend a countermeasure to deal 3 damage to it. And that should be enough. If my math is correct, which I think it is. Right? 4, 8, 12, 16... 24, 30? Nice. Woo! We did it! We defeated the blob! So we got to resolution 2. Wait, why does it skip over? Wait, what the? Where's resolution 2? Am I missing something? The Blob in resolution 2. Yeah, what the hell? Very confused. Hold on. I'm gonna go just grab my copy of it and see what's happening here. Thank you.
Weird.
That's just a typo, I guess. I wonder if that's if that was the case with the Gen Con copies of the Blob, because if you look, let me show you, chat. Let me get the bigger screen here. Oops. So hold on, let me turn the browser off. So if you look in the actual printed version of it, that is resolution 2. So it's just a mess up in TTS, I guess. That's weird. That really actually confused me. Oh, and we got another machete. Yeah, maybe. Maybe it's a mess up in the PDF, but this one looks like a scanned copy. Because if you look, you can like... you can see the line in between it. Like, it doesn't look like a scanned copy. Because I think it's... Yeah, you can even see the staples. So just note when you play this, and don't get confused like I did, this is actually resolution 2. That's weird. That's such a weird mess up. Yeah, it must have been a misprint. I wonder how many other people were like, wait, what the hell? But since the Blob no longer ate my snacks, I can finally eat my blackberries. Very upset with the Blob. Yeah, such a weird misprint. Gotta say. Alright. Incident report 8LOA continued Wednesday, July 11th, 1928. TTS is a faker. TTS is a deep fake. Blackwater, Massachusetts. 0742 hours. Contact made with subject. Subject, meteor. Researchers are unsure. Meteor served as an avenue for redacted or as some kind of redacted. Initiated immediate emergency response procedures. At roughly 0500 hours, subject was eliminated by third party. As per operational protocol, samples have been collected and sent to Redacted for further study. Agents are currently scrubbing remainder of subject's presence from the quarantine zone. Strongly recommended immediate expunging of previous conflicting incident report. Citizens of Blackwater have been informed Redacted, quarantine, Redacted, contagion of airborne virus, Redacted, several infections, Redacted, medical teams en route to confirm. Agents are attempting to meet with unlicensed combatants for debriefing. Due to sensitive nature of incident, recommend release followed by close observation. Story must be kept redacted. Destroy the incident report immediately. Additional instructions to follow. Vase. So this would be really cool to set up like a really old school Delta Green scenario. I mean, come on, it's like literally written like a Delta Green document. That would be cool. I bet you could easily modernize this to be like a Delta Green scenario. Yeah, because like, you know, government agents come in, they hold like a town under quarantine, and then the investigators have to go and deal with the contagion. So you're welcome for that idea. These blackberries are good. In your campaign log, record that the anomaly was contained. For each of the following assets that are in play, the Universal Sovereign, the Pet Oozling, the Mego Weapon, and Lieutenant Wilson Stewart, any investigator may choose to add the asset to their deck, and it does not count towards that investigator's deck size. Each investigator earns experience equal to victory X, for each card in the victory display, and each investigator earns 3 bonus experience as he or she has saved the fabric of existence. Nice. So, at first I played this on a 4-player group, and it wasn't really wowing to me, but coming back to it almost a year later at this point, I gotta say, that was a lot of fun. I mean, Pete also just crushes solo scenarios, so maybe that was it too. But But that was a lot more fun than I remember it, personally. So I'm definitely glad I replayed that. So I didn't have the best impression of it at first. And I know I definitely messed up the advancing of the act deck to put the story asset into play. So I hope that didn't really affect too much. I don't think it did. I guess I would have been able to have grabbed Wilson Stewart sooner, but and I would have had more clues to grab, but yeah. Apart from that, it wouldn't have really done much. So, that was fun. I don't really have time to play another scenario today, unfortunately. I have a Zoe deck built for Murder at the Excelsior, but unfortunately I don't have time to play it today. So that's too bad. I'll probably play it Monday though. I don't think I have. Oh no, I have. We're gonna be streaming little nightmares on Monday, which looks fun. Hopefully my computer doesn't shit the bed. I was doing some kind of just preliminary runnings of the game, and it pegs the crap out of my GPU. I was pretty surprised. As it recommends a 660 Ti. And I have a 1660 in my system right now, and I'm kind of surprised that, like, it's like 90-something percent usage on my GPU. It's crazy. I think running it at 1080 might help. We'll see. I mean, the 1660 is more built for 1080 gaming than it is for 1440 that I currently mostly play on. But I think it'll be fine. I did do a test recording, and it didn't lag or drop frames or anything, so I'm hoping that's the case when we stream it too. And if not, then I guess we'll play some Arkham Monday, and we'll play some Murder of the Excelsior. I can quickly show you the Zoe deck that I built, though. Let me pull that deck up real quick. I'm hoping the deck's good. I might have overcompensated for her ability to investigate, but I'll show you guys the deck here real quick. So, yep, yeah, and Sunday we'll be doing a stream at around 10 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, which I know is probably problematic for people on the West Coast. It's very early, but Vase, you're a trooper for getting up early all the time. Much appreciated, friend. Much appreciated. So this is the Zoe deck that I planned on taking through Excelsior. It's a well-prepared physical training deck, mostly. So I ended up going with the 32 Cult over the 45. Because my plan is to try to get well-prepared in play as soon as possible. So with that, I figured the Cult was basically the same thing, but slightly cheaper and had more ammo, and you could essentially infinitely reload it. It's always pretty good at gaining a bunch of resources. And then I think a couple of other cards that are interesting is Interrogate and Meat Cleaver and Deny Existence. I mean, Deny Existence is just a great way to cover your bases, especially in an investigator that only has 6 sanity. The only thing I fear about Zoe going into Murder at the Excelsior is that she has a low agility value. And I'm trying to remember the name of the card specifically. Is it something gas or something like that? Where you have to test agility 3 and then it can boot you out of locations and deal you horror. So that card could be pretty punishing for us. So we don't have a lot of ways to deal with it. We don't have a lot of skill cards in the deck. Ended up having to... I'm trying to go with like this more asset heavy, well prepared style deck with Zoe. Usually I end up building her like stick to the plan kind of centric events with key assets and skills. But I want to see if this well prepared style deck works out. Because if we get Zoe's cross plus well prepared and a weapon, I mean, that's plus 3, could be upwards of like pretty silly. If we had both well prepared, so it could be like a plus five. And then we also have well prepared and sixth sense too, with physical training. So we could potentially investigate at a six. So I'm hoping that works. Hoping. We'll see. Maybe I'll play it Monday and then end the stream with Little Nightmares. I'll take a vote and we'll see. I have some other plans for streaming content in the next week as well, so be sure to stay tuned for that. But I think that's going to do it for today's stream, guys. I really appreciate you taking the time to watch the game of the Blob. As always, if you're watching this on YouTube, be sure to hit that like button. It really helps my channel out a lot. And if you want to see more Arkham Horror content, be sure to subscribe. With that, I will see you all the next time you are lost in time and space.